Good day to you. I am Raymond de Souza from St. Gabriel Communications in Western Australia. St. Gabriel Communications is a Catholic ministry, a lay Catholic ministry, whose purpose is to promote the knowledge and the love of Catholic apologetics, the defense of the faith. We are headquartered in the Archdiocese of Perth in Western Australia. I'd like to invite you to join me in a series of episodes here at WTN to discuss one particular subject, which I believe has become increasingly important in the lives of families all over the world, especially Catholic families, is the question of morality. Not from the theoretical point of view, but from a very practical point of view. If we ask ourselves, for example, this question, what is good, what is evil, and who decides? Or in plain English, where does the buck stop? When do I know that something I do is good or is evil? Who is the person that decides? Now, we know in the Old Testament there is a complaint from God the Father through the prophet Isaiah when he said to the people, "Your thoughts are not my thoughts, and your ways are not my ways." And in this precisely lies our problem. We don't have the thoughts of Jesus Christ. We don't have his ways, and we battle with this. And when we mix up our choices in life, that's when sin comes into the game. That's when we do wrong. So, you're my guest in this series. What is good? What is evil? And who decides? The study I'd like to share with you in this series is on morality. I'd like to present for your consideration. And also, an examination of conscience for all of us to assess to what extent we are consonant with the mind, the thoughts and the ways of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Not so much as far as faith is concerned, that is catechism. We can talk about this another time. But mainly rules of behavior, notions of good and evil, to see if my conscience is informed enough to be given the title of Christian. Let me give you a quote from Pope John Paul II. In 1981, he was visiting Spain and talking to the Spanish youth. And he said this, "Learn to think, speak, and act in accordance with the evangelical simplicity and clarity. Yes, yes, no, no. Learn to call good, good, and evil, evil. To call black, black, and white, white. To call sin, sin, and not to call it liberation or progress, even if fashion or propaganda are opposed to this teaching." End of quote. Now, this is a characteristic teaching of Pope John Paul II, where he defines with clarity the background we must have regarding morality. See how he began his quotation? He said, "Use the evangelical simplicity and the clarity. Yes, yes, no, no." It is unfortunate that nowadays we live in a time when our culture is politically correct, and we think in terms of perhaps and maybes, and it varies according to your approach, how you feel about it. But that is not the way that Jesus Christ thought. When he said, for example, "He who is not with me is against me," or "He that does not gather together with me scatters abroad," or "Let your communication be yes, yes, no, no." The whole Sermon of the Mount, if we pay attention to it, alongside the fantastic charity and love of neighbor and love of God he displayed, there is also a clear teaching on morality. He actually perfected the law of Moses. We could say that Jesus' motto was, "Fiat voluntas tua, thy will be done." Therefore, for us, it becomes imperative to know what is that will that we must follow. If we know that by following God's will, we obtain happiness in life, by going against his will, we obtain unhappiness in life. How do we know in our daily choices? So as you see, this is something that I hope will be of help of assistance to you has been to me, to my family, and many people who may benefit from this series. Now, in his teaching, our Lord...